Hey there, YouTube. I'm Yukitsu. This is the Yukitsu Times. Welcome to my channel. Welcome back to Shogun 2 Fall of the Samurai. So, we're just starting off this episode clearing off some of these navies that are nearby us. We did build those single torpedo ships around here so that we could intercept and destroy these kind of navies. Now, it is a little bit risky trying to do this with just a single torpedo ship, because if I miss with my torpedoes, and I'm not too used to using these anymore, because I used to be really good with them, I'm not anymore, we basically instantly lose. So if I don't space these torpedoes right, then we lose the fight, and that sucks. But in any event, let's go ahead and hit that. Let's go and start deployment. Now, the big problem that I have with naval battles in Legendary is that I can't see the full length of the range indicator for the torpedo ships. There's actually a little yellow line that's in addition to the movement distance that is not actually clear where it terminates, and that's the maximum distance for your torpedoes. If you fire them off before then, you don't actually have any chance of hitting the enemy ship, even if you've got a perfectly lined up torpedo shot. And at maximum range, they're easy enough to dodge anyway. You're ideally trying to just herd your enemy into a torpedo by firing multiple torpedo salvos until they end up hitting one of them because they can't maneuver away from it. That's sort of how torpedoes work in this game. But if you can't tell if you're in range, and you do want to engage at the absolute maximum range with torpedo boats, you're going to be in a little bit of trouble. Like, for instance, here, I cannot tell if I'm in range just barely, or if my thing is still quite a ways away. So I have to crawl forward a little bit more. I'm going to set this to not full steam ahead now. I'm going to go ahead and do that, because I think we're actually just about in range. Yeah, I think we're just about in range. They're starting to make a move. We're going to go ahead and fire off our first salvo, and we're going to see which direction they start moving towards. So this first one will start shepherding them in a direction. I don't know what direction that is going to be just yet. We'll form a course correction based on that. All right, so it looks like they're going to this side. So we're going to form a correction to this side here. Fire our second salvo of torpedoes. Get ourselves at an angle for our third salvo. And as well, we don't want to necessarily be moving towards them. In fact, I might want to move astern at this point in time, if we can help it. All right. So our third volley, we're going to fire over this way. And I think that we might hit with our third. I'm going to switch this to slow again. The second one definitely looks a bit short. Third one may be on target, but maybe not. Let's go ahead and fire our fourth salvo. We'll fire at this angle. And we'll go astern again. And if we don't hit with any of these, we lose the fights, because this last reload is our last set of torpedoes. Our fourth one probably not corrected quite enough, because I think they're still going to outrun torpedo group number three. But I don't really have any great predictions as to where they were going to be for our next set. So we're just going to fire them over this way and hope for the best. And we'll put these astern. All right, so actually, torpedo group number three looks like they might be okay. We're going to move forward slow just so I can get a better glimpse of what's going on here. Yeah, three looks like they're going to slip past it, I think. They're stopping in front of our torpedoes for some damn reason. I think they're trying to turn a maneuver towards into our ship right now, so that's their mistake. Alright. Now the problem is, they didn't sink from our torpedo salvo, and they're going to miss this one. So, unless they're sinking, we've actually lost this fight, potentially. Let's go ahead and switch this to this, and hope that we can actually maybe kill them with... Oh, they're routing now. All right, let's move in as fast as we can. It doesn't matter that they're routing. We're going to continue because we actually have to destroy this ship. They might route into this last set of torpedoes, which would be beautiful. They're on a dead set collision course, but those torpedoes might be just across their nose. I think I would have got them if they had not stopped there. Looks like they're listing, actually. I think they're sinking. We must have hit them below the waterline at a point where they would sink. Because, yeah, this... They might run into the torpedo. No, just shy. Just clipped their nose, basically. All right, let's move our ship alongside these guys and start popping off shots with our extra gun, but it really doesn't matter because we've essentially killed them with that one torpedo volley. Yeah, that's a pretty severe list there. I don't think that they're going to make it. All right, end battle, heroic victory for our brave little torpedo boat. Now, one of the things that I might want to do for this next one, since there were actually two fleets near us that I needed to get rid of, is actually move these guys into reinforcing position and have both of our torpedo boats attack the enemy fleet at once so that I've got twice as many odds. And if it means that I've got 20 torpedoes instead of 10, and that's actually vitally important with torpedo boats, is the number of torpedoes that you have. The problem with that strategy is that I would potentially have to get around... What? But you sank. Quite literally bullshit. All right. Right, I can't actually move this that far. Anyway, let's go ahead and move this over here. Let's get our other torpedo boat over here. I don't know, guys. This game really pisses me off sometimes. All right, we need to again use the... Their ship sank, guys. Their ship actually sank, and then it didn't actually give me what I needed there. They were alive somehow for reasons. You would not believe how disappointed in everything I am right now. It is so bad. All right, we're going to do the exact same tactics again here with our ship. It is all about calculating where the enemy probably is going to be so that you can hit them with that torpedo. It's about making sure that you're moving astern to a certain degree so that you don't get into their line of fire. We'll still put these on explosive shell just for the hell of it, but... All right, let's go ahead and hit fast forward. I don't think it has an impact on torpedoes. It really shouldn't. I mean, all torpedoes are kind of exploding. If you had a solid shot torpedo, that would probably be pretty damn useless. But in any event, let's see where they are. They must be over there. Alright, this is a copper plated, so I guess that might be why it survived that hit, but that's still kind of extreme that they literally sank and came back to life. Especially because it brought up the victory screen, like I could not have pursued them. Maybe they hit the table edge. I don't think they did, though. Either way. We're just about in range, I think. Just a little bit further. Let's move this into normal speed here. Yeah, I'm not quite there, I don't think. The red line is even harder to see here. Alright, let's fire off our first salvo. Set ourselves at slow. Because they're going to start moving slightly towards us. I mean, we could hit astern, but... Alright, which way are they turning? Looks like they're turning left, but I've been duped into thinking that, and then they've turned right before, so... Yeah, and they're doing that again. Alright, so we want to get a good lead on this shot here. Probably about over here is fine. Let's go a little bit astern here. I'll just stop, actually. Alright, and this set of shots I think might go a little bit short, so let's go ahead and head over this way and fire these torpedoes over here. We might, of course, corrected our second volley a little bit too much, so we might want our fourth volley to be a little bit less far off. Actually, no, torpedo set 2 looks like they're pretty on course. 3 might be a little too far, actually. I don't really know where to aim this next set, because I think that torpedo set 3 is so far off ahead, but... This also means that they've got lots of time to maneuver around our torpedoes, but if torpedo set 2 hits, then we're pretty much set here. Alright, so we might want to save a set of torpedoes for a suicide run. Oh, that's looking actually really good. Yeah, we're going to save a set of torpedoes for a suicide run, just in case. No, they're actually going to dodge that. I think they're actually going to be ahead of it. Alright. No, they've stopped. I don't know why again. I think that's going to clip its back end. No, they've dodged it. Oh, crap. And they're going to manage to get around our other torpedoes then, too. All right, so we're going to try and force them to head forward, but I think that we are a little bit late on this, so... I'm going to redo this one probably because I screwed up our torpedoes by quite a bit, I think. All right, let's move our guy to full steam ahead, try and get out of his firing arc. Yeah, we're going to lose this. All right, there goes all our guns, which is fun, but let's go back and try this again. All right, so we're back. That does actually count as lost now. I don't really get what was happening the first time, because it pretty clearly sank. But, we've had to do that a couple of times now. Let's push our luck. I mean, it's not even luck. It is luck, because this is bullshit. But, all right, they've got a 14-gun wooden ship, so we're going to go ahead and try this again. I'm going to skip this because, the way this has been working has been really finicky, and I've not gotten used to it yet. I will tell you if I do, but I used to be able to do this a lot more easily. But anyway, I will be right back. Okay, so it sank again. Apparently it's still remaining. I don't understand anything that goes on in this game sometimes. All right, there it goes. That was actually a little bit easier to hit this time, but I don't know. We might be able to reach it. I doubt it, though. Yeah, no, there's no way we're going to reach it, but... let's see if we can spot it at the very least. Alright, there's where it is. I mean, I can't really get anything over there in time to stop it or anything like that, so that's all good. We can, however, get a fleet down to Hyuga to stop them from landing anything down there. And we have got a ship that's sort of over here. Might deter them from landing in Osumi, but I think they might have enough movement for it regardless. Which would be disappointing, to say the least. That doesn't even seem to have taken any damage, even though it got hit by a torpedo. Well, fantastic. I did somehow fire just one torpedo. I think it's because I was turning, and the ship would have turned directly into the torpedo. So I guess if you're trying to launch one torpedo at a time instead of two, that's how you do it. Just spin wildly. Anyway, let's go ahead and bring our Ishin Shishi down to Tsutomi so that he can start looking at what is over in Tsuruga, so we could potentially go take that. We do want to keep up momentum where possible, but again, we also have to build these rail stations so that we can keep up that momentum by following them. Mino's rail station is going to be done relatively soon. That'll get me a little bit of access, but I do have to wait until this one is finished, because that is the one that's really important to us. Let's go ahead and check our diplomacy tab here. How are the Tosa doing? Do you guys want to surrender and become our vassal yet? No? Okay. Just checking, buddy. Let's go ahead and hit next turn. Takayama, still on the warpath, still extremely deadly, still extremely dangerous. We're going to potentially have to go to war with them just so that we can meet our quota of provinces that we have to have taken over. Because that's a thing that's in this game. Right, those guys are a thing. I built another torpedo ship to try and fend them off, though, in our capital, so I guess that shouldn't be too risky, I guess? I don't know. Hopefully we'll be able to deal with them. Either way, looks like we've got a whole bunch of these guys milling around, being useless. And this guy's going to block off one of our trade routes, which is costing us some money. And those guys have just marched into their own doom, because the Takayama are gigantic. Yeah, so the Takayama should be able to take that back pretty easily. Or whatever. Actually, no, I was going to think they would push them back, but apparently they're just going to defend. Alright, Odawara, you get to do that, huh? Alright. That is such bullshit. Like, the glitches in this game, when they do happen, are so infuriating. Anyway, they've got three ships to my north. I don't really have anyone in place that can deal with that right now. I do need to defend this area, though, against this one ship here. Again, one ship that just outruns all our ships, because I haven't gotten Copper Bottom, honestly. I think that is the major thing. Either way, let's get this ship over to here. And there's actually a pretty decent chance that we'll get to use two torpedo boats against this one enemy fleet, just because they're probably actually going to let us attack, because the theoretical firepower of the Chigadate is so low that usually they're not as intimidated by them as they should be. So yeah, we get two torpedo boats, hopefully from the same side of engagement. If our torpedoes reinforcements come in from like some sort of weird side and I end up having to deal with that, then we're probably just going to outright lose this, but other than that, this is okay. Now, the benefit of this is pretty immense. We've got 10 volleys of torpedoes instead of 5, and that means we can also cover a lot more distance with a single volley. So if I'm aiming, it's got a lot more forgiveness to it, because, I mean, it's harder to weave between 4 torpedoes than it is to sort of dodge past 2. Because you can sort of turn sometimes in place and end up avoiding one of those torpedo volleys, but if you've got 2 incoming, it's actually extremely tough to dodge. Let's go ahead and just move ourselves over towards this reinforcement point and wait until we've got our reinforcements, because it did indeed come from relatively behind us-ish. Let's actually turn this to that. Where are you guys? Alright, more to the side than I thought was. And let's just full steam ahead our reinforcing ship. We'll wait till it gets here, because the enemy ship is probably dead ahead over here anyway, so... yeah, this is going to be a while. Now, if this ship survives, I'm just, like, rage quitting the game. Like, if this ship gets hit by a bunch of torpedoes and just survives, like, that's it. I'm just done, because holy crap am I ever pissed off at this game and at the way it's treating this. Because, like, the ship literally goes underwater. It's just like, oh yeah, no, you can't continue anymore because the ship's gone. And that's like, why? Why is it still there? Alright. One of the nice things about ships is they don't get tired. Alright, let's get our ships sort of lined up together. If we've got them sort of side by side, then it's a little bit easier. Although, it sometimes is a good idea to have your torpedoes going in this sort of cross formation, so that enemy ships can't go in either direction. If you sort of aim it at them, they can't really dodge in either direction safely, unless they estimate perfectly where the intersection is going to be. So that's actually really fun in online multiplayer. Anyway, let's go ahead and just zoom into a fast forward state for a second here until we can figure out where their damn ship is. All right. This is why when you're getting someone to spot for ships, you need someone with really good eyes. There it is. Right, so I've noticed that their ships always sort of, for some reason, go to my right, and I'm not entirely sure why that is, because they almost always start facing left. So that's interesting. Now, I need to figure out very carefully where the range of my torpedoes is. I can't really tell, again, because the lines in Legendary Locked Camera are a little bit stupid, but I do not feel like I am in range yet. Yeah, no, those lines are definitely not reaching there. Are not moving just yet, but what we'll do is we'll put our torpedoes like this, I think, so that one of them is on course. The other one is essentially going to block off the path that I suspect they're going to be moving in. And we'll actually slow down our movement as soon as we get into range here. Are we in range? I think we're just shy. Alright, they've started moving a little bit. I think we're just in range. We're going to go ahead and launch those first sets of torpedoes, and we're going to slow down. Alright, interesting. This guy refuses to fire for some reason. I'm going to just ignore that fact, because we're probably going to have to turn our ships anyway in just a second here. Alright, so we're at slow speed, regardless, so... I'm going to go ahead and launch our torpedo here. Alright, we're going to go astern with these guys, and we're going to continue forward a little bit with these guys so we can fire these damn torpedoes. Come on. It's safe. Alright, well that's interesting. Apparently we cannot fire our torpedoes with this boat. Okay, why does this have to happen here? Seriously. Alright, well, this is interesting. Alright, it's Alt-W to fire. Okay. Either way, let's, I guess, figure out where our torpedoes are going to go. I guess we'll fire it way over here. Let's see if we can't get... I don't know. I don't know, guys. Yeah, there's something wrong with the torpedo tubes of this ship or something. I don't understand it. Did I lose the torpedo tubes or something? No, there's no damage reported on the ship. What the hell? Alright, we're gonna have to redo this battle because one of our ships just does not refuse to actually have the weapons that it's supposed to. Okay, that's fun. Isn't that fun, everybody? At least this one's firing. It's the support ship, though. I would have figured it would have been the primary one that can't fire for some reason. Or I would have figured it would have been the support one that wouldn't be able to fire because of some sort of stupid glitch, but... No, apparently it's this one. Alright, this one launched one torpedo because it was turning, I guess, but... Let's move this over here. Might still hit this damn thing. Alright, that's one torpedo. If we can hit with one torpedo, I'll be relatively satisfied, most likely, because that'll probably actually still down this thing. What we're going to do is just suicide charge this guy up in there, because he can't fire his torpedoes anyway. Not sure why, but that is the case, it seems. And once he's sort of taken some shots or something like that, we can actually start moving this one in so that it can fire its guns as well, and try and go in for a suicidal frontal torpedo attack. Alright, they're firing at him. So, we're going to just do a torpedo charge, essentially, with this ship. We're going to go ahead and give a attack order here. I don't know. Oh, they've switched targets. We might hit them anyway, actually. That torpedo's looking okay. No, it's going to slip past. Damn. Alright. I don't know where they're shooting at this one, necessarily. That's because it moved closer. Crap. Alright, we're going to go ahead and rotate quite a bit here and then fire a torpedo. Alright. Did I get the torpedoes off at least? Yes, I did. Alright, they're going to stop and not get hit by that torpedo. This is really pissing me off. Alright, well... There's no way these are going to actually hit it now, because he's turned away from those. Managed to dodge that. Yeah, this ship's on fire. I don't know what's going on here. I'm gonna figure out what was going on with that, but yeah, we'll be back in just a minute. Okay, so we've done what we can with the very, very glitchy things going on. For some reason, for example, this group was incapable of firing two torpedoes at once. They kept firing one at a time, so the enemy got away with their damaged ship because they only got hit by one torpedo when they would have been hit by two normally. And this is problematic because they can probably slip around and land their fleet somewhere to annoy me. But that aside, things seem to be... Eh, I mean, also, that's really annoying because they were redline camping, which is always a bad thing to have to deal with. One of the other things that's interesting is that we are at the cap for the number of torpedo boats that we're allowed to have. I was not actually certain that there was a cap. Apparently there is. So that's fun. But we will go ahead and bring this fleet around over to here. We will try and add this unit of torpedoes to it. So we'll move down to here. And this will just help us start controlling enemy ships as they move to around Izu instead of way, way back near our core territories. I think that's going to be fine. Let's go ahead and take a look, though. I want to see where the next rail station might be. Maybe way, way up there. I think it might be all the way up in Musashi, but maybe not. To tell me, though, six more turns for that. That's going to be just fine. We are going to want to research the copper plating, just because I need the campaign range movement on my ships. So we'll finish learning this, and then I'm going to switch over to the copper plating right away, even though we do want that last economic tech. I mean, it's too important for me to actually get the other thing right now, so let's go ahead and ignore that. All right, Higo, what did you have here? Is this a cottage industry? Yes, it was. Let's go ahead and upgrade that. And we could also get the iron smelting plant, but I kind of want it in our more forward cannon production province, so let's go ahead and do that. Iron smelting plant, fantastic. And we actually, I think, recruited a couple cannons there. Did they finish yet? Or a cannon there, looks like. Alright, let's move these guys over to the rail system. It's a fairly long trek from Mimasuka over to the train station, but it's better than walking to wherever it is we're trying to get these guys, so there is benefits to this. And we might want to even get a few more troops sent over to Owari as soon as I can. Or not Owari, all the way down to Totomi, but it's a lot of turns before we finish the rail station there, so that's fine. That's all of our cash, basically. And let's just hope that we can hold out in a couple of these places that are acting really janky to me. This army shouldn't be too bad for us to hold out against. We did actually go ahead and build all of these upgraded fortresses, and I've got a lot of fleet here that can actually bombard them pretty badly. It's just over here as well, I'm kind of worried that these guys are going to manage to land at Satsuma. We do have these torpedo ships that can block them though, so there is that, and they are extremely damaged, so let's give this a go and find out how this is going to happen. How's this going to shake down? Looks like the Tosa... I think the Tosa are on the ropes finally, hopefully. Alright, so these guys have swept all the way to Osumi, basically. Yeah, I really need that campaign boost to movement. Capitalist production probably isn't even going to help us very much right now, so I might want... I should have probably just canceled the research to it, but... At the same time, I hate canceling research to things. Especially when you've gone so far into the tech that you just are almost done. We haven't had a great chance to use the warrior very much yet, but... this is all interesting stuff. Takayama and the Shogun are really dancing about here. Either way, let's check out what this Odawara army is about to do. Looks like it's decided that there's too much resistance down there, so it's going to move up to Bungo. I do actually have the fleet here, so I will move it up to Bungo instead. I did have to sort of scramble them apart, but that's neither here nor there. If I can get these guys up there, they should be in position by the time these guys actually attack. And of course, I might get ping-ponged back and forth until these guys get sick of that and do something. But in the meantime, let's go ahead and try our damnedest to kill this stupid set of ships, or this stupid one ship. And I'm going to skip this because it's going to be frustrating and buggy again, I'm assuming. I could actually auto-resolve this, it looks like, but... well, let's give that a shot. I can still reset that if it really is stupid. Okay, so that actually did work. Normally when it says that and it lies to me, I'm just like, why would you do that? But yeah... So, we actually got the ships this time, and I don't know how torpedo ships capture anything, that makes no sense to me. But, let's go ahead and refurbish this fleet. There we go. And let's, bring these, this navy back up this way. Up, this way. And we'll try and get them into the strait here. Hopefully that will work. These guys, I mean, it's a little bit questionable. Alright, have they got anyone raiding us anywhere, really? It doesn't look like it, so let's just regain access to trade with the Awaji. Province of Awaji. Yeah, Awaji Sumoto, so... this is a 26 gun, but it's got no veterancy. I've got four highly veteraned 14s, so... I should... Oh, that was close. And their ship technically is alive. Fantastic. But we did open up that trade port again, so that's what I was really after. I'm not going to be able to chase that because they did get that sort of wonky move that they sometimes get, where they get to go all the way around an island and only takes the same amount of movement as though they had that island didn't exist. So that's always interesting to see. Over here, I mean, I'm not sure if I'm even going to end up having to fight these guys. Those guys are getting pressed so hard by all these other guys that might not end up happening. Alright, so the Odawara are sending in an army against me. I can actually convert them if I wait until next turn, so this might be a good opportunity for me. I might be able to press forward my advantage based on them doing that. So let's go ahead and hope that that's what happens. Continue recruiting troops all around, all over the place. We might want to include more troops from here. Could also build a cottage craft workshop, sorry. And that might be good. Oh, damn it. Let me just get that. It's just more spam. I mean, pretty much constant spam. I mean, I kind of want to just unplug the phone. I think that would actually be a useful thing to do. Anyway. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's really any enemies near my borders right now that I can see, so we're just going to have to relax about that for right now. Our fleets are all getting repaired where they need to be, so that's fine. And our other things, like our train tracks, heading throughout all of Japan, are getting repaired, so that's all good. We could actually probably recruit another Ishin Shishi here, actually. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Alright, and it might be worth trying to get the Tosa to repent for their sinner kind of ways. Are they dead now? What happened to the Tosa? Oh, someone else took them. What happened? Hirado took that. The Tosa are gone, finally. Alright, so they've been stamped out for the heretical ways. I'm pretty happy about that. Alright, let's go ahead and hit next turn. Now I do not have to think about them. Alright, this navy, right, they were going towards there, and they were just going to set up and dock. I didn't see anything around, so it's not a big deal that they're not going to be active for a turn. But we do need to find somewhere to attack. Alright. Nothing going on over there. My allies are starting to pull together and start defending the coast against fleets, which is super important. Alright. Those guys are continuing to just do whatever. This geisha is probably trying to distract my army at Tomi, but they may try to steal one of my characters. Nope, no enchantment at least. Alright, that's back there. Let's pound it again, I guess. Takayama there. Alright. I didn't see any super threatening fleets so far, but that one faction does have that army landed in my territory, though, so. Alright, so we've got that big army there now. Hopefully we're going to be able to actually crush it, or convert it, rather. Yeah, my army got distracted. That's not a big deal. It's winter now, so there's going to be this problem for all invading forces. And now, this is where things get interesting. I can afford to persuade these troops, which is potentially really good if it weren't for the fact that they're all crap. How about over here? Are these guys all crap? Probably not, but they are much more veteran, it looks like. Right, so we might try that. We'll have much, much more army, and we could use them to sort of help defend at Tomi. So let's go ahead and try that out first. They're willing to take the bribe, it looks like. Alright, and we got most of that army. Alright, fantastic. Almost all of it is levy infantry. We're going to get rid of these wooden cannons. I just don't really think that they're worth paying for right now. Over here, let's go ahead and repair our navy. And let's just get these guys to join in on that. Now, if he attacks with this group into here, I'm just going to retreat back. I don't really care. But hopefully we'll be able to do some pretty interesting things around here because of that swing in numbers. Over here, let's go ahead and move this fleet into our port here. This is going to mean that we can reinforce Bungo, I believe, or we should be able to. So if he attacks here, we'll probably destroy him. There, I think, was still a threatening fleet around here somewhere. That is a really awkward-sounding British voice. It's kind of hilarious. All right, over here we... Actually, I think we did clear that out. Okay, so we need a fleet around here, though, just to keep things safe. Now that we've actually got a real ship of the line in there mixed in, that's going to become much more effective. Let's go ahead and bring these ships out to over here, just because I no longer need a fleet defending against those guys, the Tosa, because the Tosa are gone. And let's go kill this ship here. Alright, you're down to, like, no health left. There we go. Still, they've got it remaining. What the hell? What are we doing to the ship that keeps letting it get away? Either way, I'm not overly concerned by it. part of the thing, reason that I'm doing this is that there is actually a chance that I capture that ship instead of just destroying it when I do it this way. So I think that that's sort of worth the risk of not actually accomplishing anything over and over and over again. Let's get our guys on the train. Well, they're not quite there yet. Yeah, they'll be there next turn, but this means that we might build some troops at Bichu just so we can bring them down there, but I don't think we will. Either way, I think that's all we really want to be doing for this turn. Yeah, that is perfectly fine by me. Let's go ahead and get some... Yeah, this place is pretty pro-emperor now, but I could actually have him converting this place a little bit faster, and that would be fine by me. How much longer till the train station is done at Mino? One more turn until that train station is done. How many turns for Tatomi? Four more turns for Tatomi, so that's going to be quite a while. And they've got a matcha plant. It's tea. I can't remember what this icon is for. I think that's silk. Alright. Yeah, we want to fight our way to, like, Musashi, and then up to the other train stations and cut our way north. So we're going to start fighting our way that way, and hopefully it will work out okay for us. Hopefully it'll be good. We might want to just move our army forward, and actually, no, that's a tiny army. Well, that's fine. Anyway, let's go ahead and hit next turn. I don't really have much chance to advance anywhere right now. I just need to get some of my armies down there and assembled. And I have to hope that these guys actually go in and just attack me here instead of rampaging back and forth across my island. I mean, that would just be annoying. Alright, so the Hirado are around here, that's fine. I don't see any incoming navies that have devious intents towards my territories. Alright, there is this Shogunate Vanguard fleet, though. Slipped past a lot of my stuff again. And there's their Shinsengumi wandering around. Alright, they're doing that again, that's fine. They've walked into what is probably going to be fine for me. I think that I can defend that just fine. I mean, if not, I can always send in more troops via rail. Alright, I'm not getting assistance there. That's fine, though. Alright, that's a little bit peculiar. We're going to try and move our army. Enemy shinobi executed. Fantastic. Okay, well, whatever. But over here, yeah, I'm not really 100% sure what the hell they're trying to do now that they're moving down there. Either way, I'm going to try and move my army over into Tatomi. And we are going to move our navy here to support fire from the bridge battle that we're inevitably going to get into, I think, here. We could try to persuade these guys, but I don't really particularly see a reason for that. We could also try and assassinate somebody. Those are pretty expensive, it looks like, though, so we're going to ignore that for now. Alright, yeah, this is actually perfectly acceptable right now. We finished our railway connection at Mino, so I could actually get those cannons that I wanted, or that cannon and those troops, rather, up to there pretty quickly now. Let's go ahead and send them that way. Can I not reach Mino yet? Might be that I don't have enough movement points. I don't have enough movement points. Okay, well, that is perfectly fine. Just look at our train stations, though. I love those things. That's unfortunate. I was hoping that we could get there a little bit faster because of those train connections. Looks like this army's not that scary, though. I think we had a pretty good army in Mino. Yeah, and Mino also, I think, had a pretty high-level fortress with, just the high-level fortress dam. Oh, well. Anyway, that should be able to hold out, though, no problem. Alright. So with all this, one of the things that I really think I do need is more cannons, though, moving out to here. I'll wait the four turns until that finishes before I really crank up cannon production, just because it'll make them all cheaper. Let's go ahead and just check our taxes. Everyone looks happy, so that's fine. I think Tosa we were going to refurbish what they had here. So, nope, actually we already are doing that. That's fine then. And we're just going to work on economic buildings for a little while now. We are at war with, like, half of Japan, but we're in a safe spot to be at war with half of Japan. I also should actually get this gunsmith. I'll wait till next turn before I spend a lot of my money, and then we'll get the gunsmith, because that's actually going to make for very, very strong units. I don't need the iron smelting plant there, because we're going to be building cannons further up. So this is just going to be an economic problem. I might even burn that down, but there's no real point to that right now. Okay. Just doing a quick check to see what economic buildings I can upgrade. I don't like these Ricci Mahjong parlors. They're just not that economically useful. They are actually pretty good for happiness, though. So, there is a benefit to them. We could also get a master dojo, but I don't think that's very smart. Yeah, the ironworks there could potentially be good. Getting highly upgraded samurai would be really scary at just sieging everything. All right, let's get a craft workshop there. Finally found something we can upgrade. I don't really need a police station. I don't really need to upgrade my cadet school over there. I mean, it is going to mean that we're taking a lot longer to get our troops up to the front, but that is perfectly acceptable to me, is taking a little bit longer time for quality. Alright, let's go see how things work here. And this is probably going to be the last little bit of this particular episode. Now, I'm having a little bit of trouble right now, again, because we've pushed forward so far and our allies have pushed over forward so far, which means that it's just harder for me to get my armies assembled to find a place to take. And because of that, we're in this sort of weird situation where I'm having trouble crushing enemy armies. Oh, right. Forgot to clear those guys out. Looks like one of my allies did for me, so that's good. We're building like a million resource structures, though, which is great. So our economy should leap into a bit of a jump. And after that, though, it's going to start into a slide, since we're going to start buying a ton of troops again. It is nice that we're making like 9,000 bucks again. They just backed off. All right, whatever. Looks like they're sort of losing just everywhere. There's the Takayama. Okay, well, if they aren't going to attack me, it's going to become a little bit more difficult for obvious reasons for me to continue advancing. And it looks like the Takayama are starting their advance to some places, but I mean, I could just try and beat up some of their army. Okay, they just moved to Buzen. These guys are moving up. They don't want to attack me either. Okay. What we're going to do is just send our army around and try and attack their territory. One of our armies got distracted. That's fine. Where did that happen? That happened here. I hope it wasn't the one that's on the ground. Nope. All right. Let's go ahead and just move into Suruga. And that should be actually really just fine. I mean, this city here should be able to hold out if I move my cannons so that they can support. Maybe I cannot actually support this city here. Nope, there we go. All right, so now that we've got that support there, we've got an allied army just hanging out there for whatever reason. Let's see if we can persuade them. No, it's a little too expensive, right? We'll go scout over here with this guy, I think. That probably sounds like a smart idea. All right, they've got one officer over there who's not really going to probably put up much of a fuss if we just happen to walk into his city and take all his things. So that's okay. I think the army here is actually sufficient at this point in time to deal with this army as they sort of slowly die to winter, but let's also go ahead and take our shinobi and try and kill this agent. 60, that's too expensive, I think. Sabotage army, that's a little too expensive. Alright, well, let's actually not worry about it then. Okay. One of the things that we should do, though, is probably recruit an extra unit here and make sure that this is the upgraded. Oh, no, that's not. Okay. We'll have to get an upgrade to that stronghold there. And that's going to delay the blacksmith upgrade that I wanted to get, but that's okay. Have we finished the rail connection in Totomi yet? Two more turns. We can get to somewhere, though, so let's get you guys over here. Oops. All right. Let's just chug our way all the way over here. Why can I not get to here again? Do we not have open borders with everybody along the route here? Where does this rail actually go through? Up through Sioux territory. There's a little bit through the Takayama territory. Let's talk to the Takayama. Do I not have open borders with them? I'm pretty sure we do. Yeah, we have indefinite military access, so I should be able to pass my units through their Maybe it's because it's too far away. Did that not finish yet? No. Mino should be finished now. Ah, crap. I wonder what's going on here. Well, either way. Maybe it doesn't count as established yet for some reason. Maybe I actually have to control this territory. Maybe I have to conquer Omi. That would suck. Alright, well, let's hope that's not the case, but we still got our army really a lot closer than they were before. And we'll continue to march them across. We'll actually see if that train lets them go across next turn. But for now, I think... Yeah, it's one more turn for that, and then we'll start working on the copper plating. Because that 10% movement, I do need it badly. We'll move our army, or our navy rather, up to there. We're starting to really dominate navy. Alright. Now, I'm actually kind of curious if Buzin gets taken here, but I doubt it will. The defenses around there are pretty substantial. Alright, let's go ahead and just fire at these guys. They may actually take it. Okay, well, we can't actually sit on our thumbs too much for this sort of opportunity. The problem is I don't have an army here. Damn. Alright, well, that's fair. One of the things I could do is start get some Royal Marines, actually. Those are hilarious. The fact that they're as powerful as they are. They're not as good as the French Marines, but they are extremely good. I probably won't. They're just a little too expensive for me right now. Okay, let's go ahead and hit end turn. I mean, I'm trying to think of what we can actually do here, but there's not a whole lot that we can accomplish yet. Okay, there we go. And that, I think, is all we're going to do for today. So I hope you found this episode enjoyable. We're making great progress, and we'll probably actually win this legendary campaign. We've cheated a lot, but that's only because we get into really janky situations where I have to make up for the fact that the computer is functionally cheating against me, where it just disables two of my units, and it happens quite a lot. Don't know why. I really don't. So, yeah, I'm kind of pissed off about all those glitches, but that's fine. We'll probably still win. Looks like there's a friendly agent destroying these guys. And I think I'll be okay. I think we're in an okay position here. Alright, those guys are marching out to that city. They'll probably get there before I can. So I have to hope that they bounce or something, or maybe I have to sabotage that army. Okay, I don't know what's going on anymore. I really don't know what's going on right now. Okay. One of our shinobi is increased in rank. Okay, let's go ahead and not research that. Let's go ahead and research that copper plating. They've got a fairly large army here, honestly, and I don't actually know if I can actually fend them off all that easily, but we should be okay. I'm not too worried all in all. Alright, let's just get that. I don't really care. Which of those I get. This army, Shogetai, all that other good stuff here. Alright, let's go ahead and fire at these guys. Tanakachi got pretty dinged up, but nothing too serious. And the question is, do I want to try and take Suruga before these guys can get it? I don't think there's any real way that I can. Yeah, I don't think there's any real way that I can take this before they can. And this is a rail connection province. Crap. Right. Well, let's try and get our guys through the rail system this time. Yeah, something is blocking it. Railway connection between the departure point in this province is incomplete, but it really does look like it's been completed on account of there's a rail system there that goes through there. Okay, so who is... This is the Takayama. Okay. We've got our alliance and everything, so I don't really know. I may have to just, I'm probably going to have to force this into a rebellion. I hope I don't have to incite a revolt in my own province over there, but... they're pretty pro-emperor here. They've got a Shinsengumi over there as well, so these are going to be counteracting a little bit. Let's go ahead and try and incite a revolt just for the hell of it. Can't this turn? Fantastic. Right, we'll try and get our army up towards there regardless. The reason for that being that we'll try and spike them with it. We'll try and take that territory. I mean, that's so annoying that I can't actually just move through friendly territory to get access to things that I should be able to get access to, honestly. Okay, this is going to be a little bit difficult, I think. Let's move this army back here, just so that I can retake that if I have to lose it. Because I'm assuming that if I do lose, it'll be a fairly close battle. They might also opt to turn around and fight them instead. Alright. Right, that should be everything we can really do right now. So let's go ahead and get our guns upgraded over in Satsuma. Even further. The gunsmith is a great unit, or building there. And we can start building Black Bear Infantry as well as Imperial Infantry. Now, Imperial Infantry is almost as good as the Foreign Elites. The Black Bear are really accurate, but they don't have as much reload, and they don't have the same kind of rifle. But they're a lot cheaper. And I actually think that I'm just going to wait until that gunsmith finishes, because, again, if we're paying this much money for these troops, I might as well get them the best that they can possibly be. That is a massive 10 turns away, though, but, I mean, we've got a lot of time that we need to spend fiddling with things so that I can get my rail system up and running and get my units across the provinces and across the continent fast as I want to be. So, yeah, that's going to be everything we can realistically do here. I'm going to try and get some units all recruited here so that I can go march up to Buzen. But other than that, actually, no, I could get them from Satsuma. That might be actually worthwhile, is getting a bunch of these infantry from Satsuma here, and then recruiting a single one of these just crappy whatever ship. I can get a Kaiten. There's no reason for me to not get a Kaiten, I guess. And then ferry these guys up to here, so if these guys lose some of these provinces to that invading army, maybe we'll be able to swoop in and take it from them. All right, let's go ahead and swoop our navy back into here, just so that we can get them fixed up, because there were some dinged up ships in there. Let's get them up there. And that's like all our money, but I'm pretty happy with this particular solution. Anyway, I hope you found this episode enjoyable, and of course, as always, I hope to see you all next time.